What's up guys, JayzTwoCents here, and it is time to review a case. But you know, I don't like to just do straight up case reviews talking about the features. I like to actually build in the case because that's how you get a really good feel for a case. I mean, that's where you are able to decide where its shortcomings are. How did I have an IO shield just like fall out of there? That's where you decide where the shortcomings are and you actually get a good idea of what the case is all about. This was the Cougar case that I built, sort of a crudely thrown together, and the parts are definitely not cheap by any means, but the system was just thrown together with parts we had available when we moved into the studio and I needed an editing rig when I was moving the Ryzen system to some other uses, and this is that. But now what we're gonna do is we're gonna be checking out the new Cosmos C700P, which is a highly anticipated case because the Cosmos line and the half line, or the high airflow cases, those are two cases that really put Cooler Master on the map in terms of enthusiast gamers and professionals. Today's video is sponsored by Storyblocks, an amazing creative resource for all the stock images, vectors, icons, and high quality photos you can think of. Storyblocks is perfect for anyone looking to increase the professionalism of their content, whether it be web development, graphics design, print, or even online video development like myself, because you know what? I suck at creating graphics. Storyblocks member library has over 400,000 images and even an online marketplace where graphics designers can market their own designs, making it the perfect place for both creators and consumers. So if you sign up right now, we're giving away 7 free days to try it out with access to a massive variety of high-res photos, vectors, and even save 60% on marketplace content. Click the link in the description below to get started downloading and get started with Storyblocks today. I'm gonna be changing out a couple of parts in here too though. I'm not gonna be reusing my X99 system here, although a great system with a 6900K, 8 cores, 16 threads, overclocked to 4.4, definitely no slouch, but I'm trying to decide what I wanna go with moving forward. I'm thinking about putting in my 7960X, which is a 16 core, 32 thread. So I've got some concerns here about cooling, which we'll figure out. These like rubber pieces got like stuck. There we go. Wow. These are the maglev fans from Corsair, and I like them. They're fairly quiet and they have a lot of static pressure. I tend to go a little crazy on the zip ties. So then it makes case and build disassembly a little bit of a pain in the arse. My biggest complaint with Corsair fans in the past was they never gave you enough cable length. And I think they've remedied that now. You get a good amount of length on there now. Or before, like the SP120s and stuff, they didn't give you enough length, in my opinion. So my 4-gate Terabuda. My 4-gate Terabuda. My 4-gigabyte Barracuda drive that I've been editing off of, I'm gonna be switching that over to one of the 10 terabyte drives. But you know what, you guys know how I like to do this. Glamour shots time. We'll be right back. I'm gonna dab. But I honestly feel there's no better way to find the pros and the cons to a case than to kind of really push it to the limits. Even if I had just thrown in hardware off the shelf, air cooler and stuff, I don't think I would have found out some of the things about this case that I'm not really fond of. Let's go ahead and start with some of the things that are really cool about it. First of all, I've heard a lot of people complain about the orientation of motherboards. Some people really like the inverted motherboard look because you can see the cooler on your graphics card and you can see that. Sometimes it seems more natural for some people to have it upside down because then, I don't know, whatever reason, you could flip this around and make it a left side case so that the window's on the left side, it's upside down, it's inverted, so it's actually compatible with switching, the orientation depending on how you want it. So that's a really neat feature. You can actually take the drive cage and scoot it forward, scoot it back, you can make more room for front mounted radiators. Radiator support is actually pretty off the hook. You can fit up to a 420 rad in the front, so 120, 240, 280, 360 in the front, or 140, 280, 420 in the front. On the top, you can actually fit a 420 radiator in there, and you can fit it at the same time, even though Cooler Master says it's officially not supported. The problem is, because it's a center-mounted radiator, and it's not slid forward or towards the face of the case like a lot of companies are doing now, what happens is if you're running a thicker radiator than something like a 30 mil, it's gonna interfere with something like the motherboard. In fact, I'm running a 45 mil thick 360 right now. There's actually no way I'm gonna get the EPS power off without removing my radiator, because once I plugged in the power and then put the radiator down, it covers perfectly the EPS power pins, so I can't actually remove them and take them out. But on the flip side, I shouldn't really have to, because the only way I can get the motherboard out anyway is to undo the loop because it's rigid tubing. So it's kind of a, six one way, half a dozen the other. No matter what, to get this motherboard out, I have to fully disassemble it anyway, which is kind of a downside to rigid tubing, but I'm on a tangent. I digress, that's a conversation for a different video. But I've got two graphics cards in here, which is nice. They're not sagging as much as they were in my Cougar case, which is kind of interesting. But yeah, they look beautiful in there. In fact, forgot to turn the LED on that. There we go. Forgot to turn on the SLI bridge LED, my bad. Something else that's kind of nice though is they've got these shrouds all over the case. We've got the one on the bottom right here covering the PSU. I left that one in there just for the sake of cleanliness. We've also got this one that would go right here in the front, but obviously I'm leaving this one off because we don't want to cover the reservoir and the tubing as some of the best visual assets of doing a build like this. So we're gonna leave this one off. I'm gonna hand that to Nick. There's also one in the back behind the reservoir where the res is mounted, which kind of neats up cables. So as you're running cables, they're not all ugly and in the way. And since I'm running white cables in here against a black interior, cable management is a big deal because white cables would obviously stand out if they were ugly. But as you can see, we don't have too much of a problem here. With the GPU though, I routed the cables around the side like this because I don't have the front panel on, so I could do that, or that front shroud, because with the SLI spacing in this particular motherboard, it pushed the lower graphics card really close to the pass-through grommet, which made it very ugly and hard to get a good tidy run because it's offset, because these cards are longer, where normally that grommet's lined up with like the Founders Edition cards. So the tubing or the cables could come straight through and go right into the graphics card and look clean. These were offset because they're longer cards, and so it had this crazy bend that just didn't look good. So this is the better, cleaner routing option for me. Full length filters on the bottom, on the top, and on the face, so that you're able to easily pull out the filters. Everything, you have dust minimized inside of your case, you blow these out and off you go. But let's go ahead and talk about something that I'm not a fan of with this case, and that's the fact that it only gives you 2 3.5-inch drive sleds. And when I kind of complained about that to Cooler Master, their response was they had listened to feedback over time of various cases where people wanted more water cooling and reservoir support and less hard drive cages. So they kind of came up with this mounting sled, sort of a hovering mounting sled, which actually looks an awful lot like the Inwin sleds that I used in the Tau 2.0 case in the Terry Crews build. But regardless, I'm only using one of them because I have 1 3.5-inch drive in here. But one of the things that was amazing about the Cosmos 2 was the amount of native 3.5-inch and 2.5-inch drive support that you had with all of those drive sleds. And you kind of lose that with this. So that's some of its heritage that you're not getting here. And it did say you can purchase those separately, but they're $5.99 each on a case that's already about 300 bucks. If you have to buy 5 or 6 more of those to get all your hard drives in there at $6 a pop, and it's another 30, 35 bucks just to add something that was previously on an additional case that's really expensive, or on an expensive case. So that's kind of a downside to me. But this case looks amazing. It's got built-in case lighting. You can see right here, you can cycle through it. Where's the button? You can cycle through it for static. It's also got RGB stuff going on, I just leave it on white. It does cycle and whatnot, but it shares a lot of heritage from the Cosmos too. These rails are all metal. They do support the entire chassis, and this is not a light build by any means. So we've been moving it all around. We were filling it and having to tilt it and put it upside down and on its back. We were using those handles. Trust me, they came in handy. So moving the case wouldn't be too hard because of the support of those rails. But again, it's a very heavy case and something worth keeping in mind. But ultimately, I don't have too many gripes about this case. And I know a lot of you guys have been really asking me about, yeah, the C700, that's awesome. But what about the H500? That's coming, guys. It's got a later embargo date. I will be doing something with that. I don't know if it'll be to this caliber, but I will be doing something because, again, the Half Series is a highly anticipated case that a lot of people want to know about because there was a huge fan base for the higher flow series, and they're bringing that back as well. So anyway, guys, it's time to go. Thanks for watching my look here at the C700P. Basically, my look is just doing a build in it. Hit the like button if you guys enjoy this build. I basically did a build that would normally take me several days and crammed it into 2 days, actually a little less than 2 days. I think it turned out pretty damn good, especially that view fluid. You guys wanted me to use the blue in the Threadripper build so badly, but I decided I'm using silver in Threadripper, and the blue fits in here perfect contrast with the white and the gunmetal and the black. I don't think it could have looked any better. I know some people were disappointed that I didn't watercool the graphics cards, but I wanted to keep using my Furtherwind 3 cards because they're so damn powerful, and it's gonna be nice now for me to try out different graphics cards too on my main system, which I wasn't able to ever do with Skunkworks because they were hard-lined watercooled graphics cards. So now I can at least play around with that, and with the modern cooling now, no problems there. I mean, the graphics cards run so damn cool now with the custom coolers, there's not really a problem. That's why I made at least the LEDs match, right? Because then you can kind of, it sort of ties in. But time to go, guys. Thanks for watching. Make sure you guys mash that like button. Merchandise link is down in the description below. Hundreds and hundreds of shirts sold in the first month that this has been up. So huge thank you if you guys have supported that way. And as always, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.